along vertical direction. The force is only capital B small b omega square sin theta, and due to the reciprocating masses it would be a zero. This would be a maximum at theta is equal to 90 degree, means when we have a crank in the vertical direction upward or downward. So, the value is equal to capital B small b omega square, and this is nothing but you can say that C times whatever the m is there, r is there and omega square is there. And the maximum force in vertical direction would be equal to whatever be the value we have taken here as a BB, capital B small b omega square. This unbalanced force is acting here in the vertical direction, means whatever the rail is there or it is making to lift the wheel from the rail. So, this one is known as a hammer blow. Also, this capital B small b omega square, this is a force that is acting upward direction, means when we have a crank 90 degree that should be taken by our the mass into the G. So, here from this equation we can say that omega square is equal to mg by B, B. So, omega is nothing but the speed. So, speed is controlled by whatever be the masses are acting on the vehicle. If we have a less mass, certainly we have to keep the speed less. If mass is there, then the speed would be, if mass is more, the speed would may be kept more. So, the speed is controlled by the whatever be the mass is acting on it or the total mass of the vehicle. So, up to now what we have discussed about the analytical method and graphical method of the rotating masses in the different planes, as well as we have taken the balancing of the reciprocating masses of the single cylinder horizontal engine, and we have taken the unbalanced force in the vertical direction and horizontal direction. In the vertical direction, the unbalanced force that was taken as a, we have taken as a hammer blow. Thank you.